The Melbourne boss received some early assurance that his team was on their game when Gareth Widdop found a charging New Zealand-born back rower.
He looks for Widdop, he gets it to Manu, Manu scores! Sika Manu scores! Sika Manu with the northern end has scored for Melbourne off the back of a penalty on the late tackle.
This match was developing into a carbon copy of that April encounter between the two clubs, with the Storm striking inside the first five and the visitors replying on the end of a high kick.
Puts the kick over, here's Inu! Came backwards, dived on by Tupo! Try New Zealand! Try the Warriors!
Well, it was great!
A three-match check and points to the spot.
Another bomb drew a blunder from Dally M Player of the Year, Billy Slater. And it was seized upon in the following set when Michael Luck served up a sweet short ball.
Michael Luck with the right side play, Maloney will score! James Maloney scores for the Warriors. Well, the village of Arimba, and I think the pub's called the Tall Timbers, you'd be loving it.
The Warriors were looking dangerous and confident, with the defence continually being tested.
Here's Mateo Maloney and then Mannering. No look, might have gone forward, it did.
Simon Mannering's errant pass not only cost his side a scoring opportunity, but offered Slater a shot at redemption.
Oh, Slater's got the ball away! And Bo Champion, he's sprinting away! Locke's after him, but he beats Locke to the line! Champion scores! 70-metre try!
That sizzling burst by the ex-South centre was duly converted by Cameron Smith. But after levelling things up, the Storm skipper was pinged for an illegal strip. And with a minute to go before the break, James Maloney pointed to the sticks before anyone could even blink.
He strikes it, the touches haven't moved, the flags go up.
That penalty goal by the Warriors pivot was all that stood between the combatants after 40 minutes of high-powered football. Kevin Locke was left checking that everything was in the right place, following a bump from Smith that went without penalty. The dashing Warriors custodian might have still been a bit dazed from that when he entertained a low percentage option down the touchline.
It's turned on the afterburners. It's gone down the ground and then it finds touch.
Ivan Cleary wasn't too thrilled by Locke's flirtation with the chalk, and his flashy fullback wasn't smiling either after copping more attention around the melon, this time from Champion's coat hanger, which resulted in the assailant being put on report. The tension kept rising as the match matured, with the Aucklanders endeavouring to extend their slender advantage.
So it'll be the... No, it won't be the kick. He's gone for the hand. And it's gone out to Locke, and he's got the ball away. And Tupo throws a pass. It's gone to ground. It's come away from Locke. It went backwards, the pass. Maloney rolls it in. Brown will score. Brown scores for the Warriors. It will go under inspection.
Before the men in white could celebrate too much, though, a review of the video detected a tiny fumble by Locke in the lead-up. But after missing out on that one, Lewis Brown bobbed up again to capitalise on Sean Johnson's dazzling footwork.
Then gets the pass to Johnson. Johnson's still going. Dummies again, Johnson!
Yes.
Gets it away to Brown! Brown! Brown goes in to score!
The margin was six with a couple of minutes still remaining, leaving Maloney to set the result in concrete and sink his former club.
Maloney, it looks okay! He's kicked the goal! Maloney has booted them into the grand final!
What an upset, what a game, and what a night for the New Zealand Warriors, triumphant by 20 points to 12 to qualify for the club's first grand final since 2002.
It's been a dream from the club, you know, for a very long time now, and just cannot believe it, you know, I can't describe it.
So it's the much maligned Warriors to meet Manly in this year's Telstra Premiership decider at ANZ Stadium on Sunday, October 2. A showdown that shapes as a classic.